I've heard that before.
About to come down.
Yeah,
down
here he comes.
North Carolina, weighing 250 pounds, Tatanka.
Native American Tatanka.
From the outer reaches of your mind, weighing 269 pounds, Damian Demento.
What a matchup here to begin things on Monday Night Raw. We are live. We're happening from New York City's Manhattan Center. Rob Bartlett, along with a macho man, Randy Savage, and Vince McMahon.
It's cold outside, but it's hot in here. We're all the way live, and we're uncut.
Uncensored.
And uncooked.
Yeah, you bet. And Tatanka getting ready to lock up with Damian Demento. Series of the headbutts to the rope now. Tatanka, it's going to be a quick match. One, two, and three. No. Count of two. Tatanka almost putting the pin on Damian Demento here in the early stages of the matchup. A little bit later on here tonight, you'll see high energy in a tag team matchup. And of course, our feature attraction will see Typhoon squaring off against that evil clown, Doink. Look at this. Tatanka exerting the power. Toes line over goes Demento. Whoa!
Away from me.
Well, wait a minute. What he doesn't know is coming up from behind, Tatanka.
Oh, what a shot! Boys, you want to take that back in the ring? Thank you.
Yeah. Right out here in front of us. Tatanka taking it to Demento. Oh, my goodness.
I love it.
Demento getting signals from the skybox. He thinks he's back at the Super Bowl. Charging another chop. There he goes.
By the way, Vince, you owe me 50 bucks.
Yeah, well, that's beside the point. Tatanka backing Demento to the corner now. Oh, look at that. And ladies and gentlemen, a very special interview. A little bit later on with Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Welcome back, Brutus.
Ooh, oh, what a close line that was.
You know, after yesterday's game, I think Mitch Marat's a lot closer to joining the WWF than he originally thought.
Well, he certainly welcome, that's for sure. Congratulations to the Dallas Cowboys. And Tatanka now off the rope. Boom! Very competitive matchup here, opening up things on Monday Night Raw, live and down the leg.
Big tough match right here.
And a cover. Not much of one. You're not going to be able to pin a man the caliber of Tatanka that fashion. You're going to have to hook the leg and cinch it up to the inside of the thigh. Lower abdominal region.
I hope so.
It was referee right there. And pouring it on now. Damian Demento, another cover. Another kick out.
I got to point out right now that Tatanka is undefeated so far because when he came into the World Wrestling Federation. But right now he's going against Damian Demento live Monday Night Raw, and anything can happen.
You know, when I was a kid, I used to have a couple of his trucks.
Tatanka?
Tatanka trucks?
Yeah, right.
Those kind of remarks hurt.
Tatanka has to figure some measure of escape here. Damian Demento has him down on the canvas. And it could very well be that undefeated streak you pointed to, made mention of earlier, Macho, could be slipping right through the fingers of Tatanka.
Exactly. The competition of the World Wrestling Federation is the toughest I've ever seen it.
Tatanka making his move now. Series of elbows to the abdomen. Off the rope, Tatanka with a boot, and he just collapses right there in front of you.
You know, the mystery about Damian Demento's over now.
What's that?
He's Ruth Buzzy's love child.
He is?
Uh-oh.
Tatanka trying to build ahead of steam. Demento crashing down the shoulder area. Look at this. Trying to set him up now. Tatanka sending Demento off the rope, and oh, what a chop that was.
Big time momentum on that chop.
Tatanka with Demento as he up, and yes! A cover, he looks the leg, two and a count of three. Yeah.
Still undefeated.
Here is your winner, Tatanka.
Tatanka, victorious. What an ovation!
with a Native American who is still undefeated, Tatanka, one of the many superstars.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest at this time, unquestionably one of the all-time greats in the World Wrestling Federation. Would you welcome, please, the one and the only, Brutus the Barber Beefcake!
Unbelievable, this guy is back!
Looks like he got a little too close with those snippers.
Fans love him. They haven't forgotten him one bit.
Brutus the Barber, what an ovation. Just has to make you feel real, real good.
Makes me feel great, Vince McMahon. I feel like a million dollars.
We haven't seen you since that devastating and near fatal parasailing accident. Good to have you back.
Well, it's great to be back, Vince. And I came here for one reason tonight, and that's to make a very important announcement. Okay. I intend to return to the WWF, to return to the ring, to return to the strutting and the cutting, and to take on all comers, whoever they may be.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake is back. I have to say, though, Brutus, I'm sure that I'm not the only individual who is certainly concerned with this comeback. I mean, considering the extent of the near-fatal accident, your whole face was totally reconstructed. To me, this is a very, very risky maneuver.
Yes, Vince, it is. You could say it could be a risky involvement here. But I just came out here to give you a little bit of background and to let you know just exactly how and why I arrived at this decision. Let me tell you, let me just start it out. Let me lay it out for you like this.
Please do.
Just before the accident, after a lengthy bout with cancer, I lay my frail 85-pound mother in the grave. Yeah. Okay, and not shortly after, I lay my father, who died of a heart attack, half from grief, half from sorrow, right next to her.
This is all prior to the accident.
This is before the accident. And then when things were pretty bad, Vince, and I was down, and I reached out for my wife, she slapped me upside the head with divorce papers and took off with some barfly with everything I had.
All of this is prior to the accident. Nobody knew that.
Well, you know something, Vince? Notwithstanding all this, and I was pretty down at this point and a pretty desperate man and broke and desperate, as I was walking along the beach and looking up into the sun, ba-boom! The knees of a girl parasailing smashed me in the face and shattered my skull in a million pieces. You know, my eyes were squashed into the back of my head, but my ears were still working. And as I was whisked off in the helicopter to the trauma center, I heard them talking. I heard what they said, and there wasn't much of a chance for me at this point. The next thing I knew, I was in the hospital, surrounded by doctors, and once again, I was listening. They weren't giving me much of a chance. I was laying there without so much as an aspirin for 24 hours, waiting for them to decide what to do with me.
Going on in your mind?
Vince, I was beaten down. I was about to give up. I felt the life blood oozing from my body. I was reaching out with my hands. I was putting myself in God's hands. When another hand reached out and grabbed me. That hand was none other than the hand of Hulk Hogan.
He's always been your friend to the end, Brutus.
Always. Not more than that, Vince McMahon. Hulk was right there as I came out of surgery with my eyes sewn shut, a steel bolt through my nose, holding my forehead on, my jaws wired shut with steel, 8 steel plates, 30 screws, 500 stitches later, Hulkster was there as they pulled the bandages. And as I saw a glimpse of light through the big, fat, swelled up eyes, the first thing that I saw was the red and yellow standing over me. And he was saying, "Don't give up, Brutus. You gotta fight, because me and all the Hulkamaniacs are behind you all the way. And no matter what happens, you'll be taken care of." Well, from that point on, from my first step to my time I left the hospital to the time that I was back to my feet and regaining my strength, the Hulk was there all the time.
But Brutus, even still with all of that, and obviously you look in great condition still, it seems to me an unbelievable risk you getting back into the ring.
That's true, Vince. But at this point, I'm a desperate man. I've got nothing left. Everything is gone. My career, everything is down the tubes. I went to the Hulkster, and as I looked him in the eye, he came with the answer before I could give the question. And his answer was, "Go for it, Brutus. Go for it."
Well, with the good man, or the big man, looking over your shoulder, and Hulkster certainly encouraging, that's quite a tag team, isn't it?
That's right, Vince McMahon, because after all this, and after all I've suffered, do you think that someone can actually hurt me? That you think, after all this suffering, that a little bit of pain in this ring is going to be enough to make me give up, to make me quit? Not a chance. Not a chance.
So you're back to take on all comers.
That's right. Anybody who wants to step in the ring with me, I've signed an open contract, and I'll take on anybody. I don't care how big or how small.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake, he's back.
Oh, yeah. Bob Bartlett, winners never quit and quitters never win. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, I guess he's gonna go for it, just like Hulk Hogan says. And maybe he's gonna go all the way to WrestleMania. Don't count him out. No way.
He's gonna go for it, just like that.
It's scheduled for one fall. And here comes the clown.
Coming down the aisle.
Anything but funny.
I don't even like the music. You dig where I'm coming from?
The clown.
Don't you think Doink is really one of those clowns who's crying on the inside?
No, I don't think this man is sensitive at all.
Ah, come on, like one of those sad red skeleton paintings?
Uh-uh, not this guy.
What about Crush, Rob Bartlett? You think he's doing real, real good right now? I'm hoping the big comeback zeroes in on this guy right here. He's infamous, okay, because he took the big man down.
From behind, I'm
from behind, behind, exactly.
Kona Crush looking forward to his shot, however. Here comes a man who can really give him a driving.
384 pounds, Todd Boone.
Take a look at the size of Typhoon.
One half of the natural disaster zeroing in on Doink.
Doink, somewhat of an individual of contrast. You would think most clowns like to make children laugh. This guy likes to make them cry. He's dressed in this ridiculous-looking outfit. You wouldn't think he would have any idea what he's doing in the squared circle. However, as you have already seen with a series of maneuvers and holds, Doink is a very accomplished wrestler.
Well, that's what really makes me mad about him right now. I just wish it was easy pickings, but he's not. Look, he took this guy down again.
You know, he belongs to Clowns Anonymous.
What a different style he has, Vince McMahon. It's unbelievable.
Than anybody else. And again, Doink. With a maneuver, a referee might get over there and check to see if that forearm is underneath the chin. Big Typhoon back to his feet, and there you see the strength of Typhoon.
Like that.
And Doink knows full well he's going to have to counter with the girth and size of Typhoon.
Did you see the way Typhoon was looking at Doink? A little bit puzzling.
Yeah, with respect, no doubt of that. I mean, it's tough to look at a man who looks like Doink. Look at that maneuver. And at the same time, recognize that he has extraordinary wrestling skill.
He's got balance. Did you see that? He took Typhoon down with balance.
Wrist lock. And Doink applying hold after hold on the big man.
You know, I know Crush is watching this right now, and I just like to say, get better, big man. And zero in on this guy.
Oh, he's going to be back.
I don't think he really wants to be a clown.
I think you're doing what? Bartlett's doing a heck of a job.
He should head to one of those 12-step programs, you know, when he gets the urge to take a pie in the face, he calls somebody.
I see.
Can you believe he's got Typhoon down right now?
No. Typhoon trying to make a move here on Doink.
Have a bumper sticker on his little clown car, another friend of Bozo's.
There you go. And again, to the buckle now.
All right, take that.
And Typhoon with a knee.
No.
Typhoon perhaps in control. To the far side out and, oh yes. Oh, look at that, rake of the eyes and face. Wait a minute, what's going on here? Back to a front face lock, spins around, nice balance, riding him a little high, drives his face down the canvas just for good measure. Southpaw, forearm to the head area.
Typhoon's off to a slow start, but I think he's gonna get the momentum right now.
Look at this, look at Doink,
right.
Chopping away on the big man. And look at this, he's caught in midair! Big power slam by Typhoon!
That's what I've been waiting for right there.
And now Typhoon taking over here on Doink, has him cornered. And a whip to the bumper. Here it comes Typhoon. Oh. Doink now, back to the corner. And hooks him one. Wait a minute, he has his tights.
A handful of tights.
Gave a wedgie.
Well, here is your winner, Doink the Clown.
He just fell with Typhoon.
Doink the Clown, Point Doink. Well, that's exactly what Typhoon attempted to do.
Real
sure
nice
what Crush would like to do as well. Nonetheless, in the record book, it'll show a victory for that man right there, Doink.
Ladies and gentlemen, as many of you know, one of the legends last week passed away. And I'm referring to Andre the Giant. Andre, throughout his World Wrestling Federation career, provided many an exciting moment for both young and old alike. And his unique presence will surely be missed. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to ask you all to rise in tribute to a man who truly was one of a kind, Andre the Giant.
Joining us right now, ladies and gentlemen, the tag team champions of the World Wrestling Federation, Erwin R. Scheister, Ted DiBiase. Here they are, Money Incorporated.
Everybody's got a price. gonna pay. Cause the Million Dollar Man.
All right, Ted DiBiase. Owen R. Scheister, that has to bother you. You come out here to a capacity crowd, what do you hear?
The only thing that bothers me, McMahon, is an empty bank account, and I'll never have that.
All right, gentlemen, you asked for this time. Go ahead. What do you have to say?
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall, but all the king's men and all the king's horses couldn't put Humpty back together again.
Okay, and what's that supposed to mean?
It's very simple, McMahon. My partner Irwin and I are sitting back in the back, and we saw Brutus the Barber Beefcake come out here and pour out that sweet sob story. And I'll have to admit, it's a pretty sad story. The guy loses his mother, then he loses his father, then he loses his wife, and if that's not bad enough, he gets his face smashed. And that's bad. But I'm here to say that when you got your face smashed, Beefcake, you knocked the screw loose, pardon the pun. Because for you to come out here after 3 years of never being in the ring and offer an open challenge to any wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation, you got a lot of gall. That's like a slap in the face. So let's cut through all the small talk and get to the point. You want a match? We'll give you a match. Why don't you start out with a champion? And you got your choice of two right here, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Both of us would like to have a shot at you. So you take your pick. No, better yet, Irwin, let's do this the Democratic way, because I know you want the shot too. Let's flip a coin. Have you got a coin?
Wait a minute.
Just a minute. Let him flip the coin. See who gets him.
Heads, I win.
All right.
I win. So it looks like, Beefcake, if you want to accept the challenge, the open contract, it's going to be the Million Dollar Man.
Jimmy Hart, where have you been? Did you put them up to this? What are you doing?
Well, you know, this is ridiculous. This is a waste of time, guys. Let me tell you something. We're the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Irwin, if you get in the ring with Brutus and you get hurt, it's over, baby.
Don't worry about
DiBiase, if you get in the ring with Brutus and get hurt, it's over for us as a tag team, man.
Calm down, Jimmy. Calm down. This is strictly recreational. Look, you're our manager. It's a workout, exactly. You think that this man or myself is going to climb in a ring with a guy that hasn't been in the ring for 3 years, and you're worried about one of us getting hurt? If anybody gets hurt, Jimmy, it's going to be Beefcake, and we know where and how to hurt him.
What do you mean by that? What do you mean?
Minute,
let me tell you.
Let me talk here. Wait a minute. First of all, Beefcake, you're breaking our hearts with this sad, sad story. But let me point something out to you, Beefcake. While you're laying on your back, all those doctor bills collect and realize that you're not paying any tax. So that makes you no better than every one of these stinking tax chiefs right here and all over the world. And Beefcake, that's your biggest mistake. You're not paying your fair share.
That's right, Irwin. In addition to that, the way I see it, in addition to being a tax cheat, Beefcake, you've only got one asset left. You are destitute, you're penniless, you've had it bad. But the only asset he's got left is that million-dollar face. And you know, we wouldn't do anything to that.
Look, why don't both you guys quit clowning around? We've got contracts to sign, we've got matches to talk about, so let's go.
You want a soda?
No!
All right, I'm just gonna sit down here. Are you sure? You don't wanna... What the...
Well, I guess now everybody knows exactly what the big bomb is that I spoke about in the past. Undertaker, You ruined the once mighty Kamala with what you did to him. Now, it's only fitting that you're ruined, Undertaker, after what the giant Gonzalez has done to you.
Undertaker, now is your funeral.
At the Royal Rumble, there was an unveiling. Bobby the Brain Heenan unveiled the narcissist, Lex Luger, and said, he's beyond perfection? And Lex Luger, you challenged Mr. Perfect to a match? Hey, you look pretty good now, I'll have to hand it to you. But you step inside the ring with Mr. Perfect, and here's what you'll look like. Here's an unveiling. Here's the narcissist, Lex Luger. Give it to me. Give me that bicep. Give me the most muscular. Get a little bit closer up here. You know, there's only one thing missing from this man's physique right now. Narcissist, this is Mr. Perfect's trademark, and this is for you, Luger.
The competitors here in the World Wrestling Federation follow the discipline of integrated conditioning programs. They all know what it means to train naturally, to gain an advantage, to gain an edge over your competition. Speaking of competition, right now, ladies and gentlemen, yes, indeed, what a matchup this is going to be. Can Hacksaw Jim Duggan, representing the United States, knock that man off his feet? Yokozuna, representing Japan. This capacity crowd, I believe, very impressed, you know, with the sheer size of this man, Yokozuna.
I could save us all a lot of time. Right. I could just tell you right now, no, he cannot. No more than the Macho Man, no more than Mr. Perfect could. Nobody can knock Yokozuna off his feet. I'm talking nobody.
Disregarding everything you said just then, I am looking forward to this confrontation, the challenge accepted by Yokozuna and Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
What was the look in Jim Duggan's eyes? You saw him before the broadcast.
1,000,000% intensity. He is driven right now. He is representing the USA.
It was fear. It was fear. That's
maybe, but that fear could very well work to Mr. Duggan's advantage. Hacksaw Jim Duggan at 285 pounds, I believe. He's a big man in his own right. Standing by right now, Raymond Rougeau, I believe, with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Ray?
Hacksaw, last week you made the challenge. Now, do you feel confident you can knock Yokozuna off his feet?
Just like our troops did in Kuwait, just like our troops did in Desert Storm, just like our troops are doing now in Somalia. Success, the big man's going down.
Hey! Well, he is jacked to the max, no doubt about that. Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Let me tell you something about this guy. He is a big man. And let me give one hole for Hacksaw Jim Duggan, because I like what he's all about. And he's all about what he's carrying right there. And that's the United States flag. Go get him, Hacksaw.
Sure, they would love to think that the Japanese aren't right when they accuse the Americans of being lazy. Sure, they would love to think the American products aren't as good as the Japanese. But unfortunately, none of that stuff is true. What's going to happen here is all of these people are going to go home with a big sad look on their face when they realize that Jim Duggan can't get the job done.
Vicarious thrill right now. I feel like I'm in there with Hacksaw.
It's Japan versus the United States. It's Japan versus the West. East versus West. Right here in the World Wrestling Federation. And look at the stoic look on the cursor of that man right there. We'll be right back with Yokozuna versus Duggan for the challenge. Well, we're back with WWF Action, and action we're going to have in just a moment. A stare down here with Hacksaw Jim Duggan, looking right in the eyes of Yokozuna. Now, this is not a sanctioned match, ladies and gentlemen. Let me set it up for you. Indeed,
Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna stated, no one can knock the big man down. No one can knock Yokozuna off his feet. Hacksaw Jim Duggan is going to prove he can do just that.
You're the stare down. Nobody blink.
Let me just paraphrase what all you just said. Hacksaw Jim Duggan has bitten off more than he can chew.
He's ready right now. Yeah. Duggan's ready to go. Look at this.
Sure, he'd love to try to jump Yokozuna before he's
Whoa.
Ready.
No doubt, Yokozuna.
505 pounds, Yokozuna, former sumo wrestler, grand champion. He does possess unbelievable balance and athletic prowess. I'll give him that.
He really does.
He got hit by a car once in his native country. They asked the driver what happened. He said, I didn't have enough gas to go around him. That's how big this man is. And you think Hacksaw Jim Duggan could get him off his feet? You're crazy. You're both crazy.
Again, though. What it is to be in front of a home team crowd.
Feel the momentum. Chills up and down my spine. Hacksaw, I'm with you, brother. Do it for everyone. Do it for the USA. Yeah.
Ask the San Francisco 49ers what it's like to be in front of a hometown crowd. Or the Miami Dolphins. They both lost in front of their hometown crowd. And so is Duggan.
Look at this.
Budge him.
It's not over yet. I think Hacksaw Jim Duggan wants to try it again.
It'll be hard to get the momentum up.
Listen to these fans. Save yourself the embarrassment, Duggan. Go back to the dressing room. Where with Hacksaw. Hacksaw's down. Even more determined than ever. Now he's set again. Hacksaw Jim Duggan looking into Yokozuna. Yokozuna takes his time. Readies himself.
Yokozuna favoring that shoulder just a bit. Will he try it again or is it history?
Well, you'll try it. Hacksaw's that type of person.
Here he goes. Here he goes. How many times are they going to let him do this? He's already proven he can't do it.
Hey, listen.
This should be over right now.
Thing right now. Come on, Hacksaw. Get the momentum.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan psyching himself up. Going round and round Yokozuna. Hacksaw Jim Duggan. He has to do it. He has to do it.
He can't do it.
Going down.
Here we go now, ready for a third collision, and Jim Duggan fiery out of the hole, and a it out all over again. Hacksaw Jim Duggan is the victor. You can't take that away from him. But that's exactly what Yokozuna and Fuji are trying to do. What a great competitor. Hacksaw Jim Duggan gave it everything he had for himself, for his family, and for his country. Oh, no. Come on. Get in there. Somebody's got to do something. Don't let that happen. No. Don't let that happen. Duggan's not moving. Duggan's not moving at all. Get him out of there. He gave it everything he had, but look what he's going to have to show for it.
Razor Ramon, Mr. Machismo. You walk macho, you talk macho, but I wonder what's gonna happen next week when you're in a ring with me, looking me eye to eye. Well, I'll tell you what's gonna happen. I'm gonna teach you what machismo is all about.
Yo, Typhoon, oy, I'm a big man. You right, Chico. I am oozing machismo. And you right again, right here. Next week, you gotta face the bad guy. And Chico, I'm gonna carve you up.
And here we go! Here comes the Heartbreak Kid himself!
The first title match.
Take a look at the reigning Intercontinental Champion. You might want to listen to his vocals. He's been in the recording studio. I think he fancies himself as the next Elvis. Take a look at Shawn Michaels. Let's listen to him as he sings his way to the ring.
Self-proclaimed in all his glory, there's a guy waiting to come into the ring right now, and his name is Tatanka, and he's looking to beat this guy.
Yeah, but look at this. The girls are going crazy over Shawn Michaels. Look at that song. That could be the next number one. Number one with a bullet.
I make them beat. I hit them all in cloud nine. I'm just a sexy boy.
Hey, just a sexy boy. And look who's coming to town now.
Here we go. Tatanka, come and get him.
Yet.
Tatanka looks in super shape. He hasn't been in the recording studio.
Tatanka very much looking forward to this matchup, even though it's a non-title matchup. A win over Shawn Michaels, I believe, would catapult Tatanka certainly in the top five category in terms of an opportunity to perhaps one day take the title away from Shawn Michaels.
No doubt about it. Tatanka's got the edge mentally, yes.
Well, if you could win matches with your mouth, you guys would be world champions. But he can't do it. He's going to have
to... Pardon me. The Macho Man has been World Wrestling Federation champion on two different occasions, and he backs up what he said.
Thank you very much.
Well, let me just say this. I am the only one in there that is sufficiently articulate enough to brag on Shawn Michaels. And I'm going to tell you right now, this kid is great. Look at that move right there.
Yeah, well, we just saw that. Histrionics there on Shawn Michaels, who decides to take a hike. Tatanka going right out after him now. These two great competitors. Oh, wait a minute. What a move that was by Shawn Michaels.
A very smart move.
Yes, it was.
Used to be a wrestling match. May turn into a fight.
Never can tell here in the WWF. Two great competitors, and Tatanka puts on the brakes a second time. Oh, look at that maneuver by Shawn Michaels. Nicely done. But it did nothing for him offensively. Oh, yeah.
Cheap shot.
Never turn your
what
back.
Shot.
I love it.
Tatanka with a clothesline. All the way from the outside. Shawn Michaels, the Intercontinental Champion.
Well, going after him there, Tatanka, if you're so tough. I think he's got red on the head, but yellow down his back.
Oh, no, I don't think so at all. I don't think you can say that about either one of these competitors.
Shawn Michaels doesn't look like much of a sexy boy right now.
No. But you never can tell whether or not Michaels is playing possum. He's always thinking out there. There's no way to really read the Intercontinental Champion. There you go again.
Right.
I love it. This guy's so smart. He reminds me of me.
Shawn Michaels winding up Tatanka. A nice reversal by Tatanka.
Michaels now with the Tatanka. He's coming off the ropes. Right back to the net. Oh, yeah. Off the other side. And it stops right about there. Down on the knee. Oh. Cover one. Two or three.
No. Two great athletes. I think strength goes to Tatanka, though.
Tatanka with a quick cover again.
Real close.
Several near falls there by Tatanka with momentum now.
There you go.
Shawn Michaels in what would appear to be somewhat of a desperation attempt, nonetheless successful, heaving Tatanka over the top rope, and that was literally a charging bull.
Shawn Michaels used Tatanka's momentum against him right there. Smart move, I have to say.
I can't believe you would admit that.
I did it. I admitted it.
Ooh, look at that. Another smart move.
Hard right hand on the part of Michaels. Back in now. Admonishment from the official. Tatanka trying to shake it off.
Well, look at this.
Come on.
You think Tatanka might be thinking about his ancestors right now?
And look at this. Michaels turning it into a slugfest. Hammering away on Tatanka. I don't think that's too smart. Snapmare over goes Tatanka. Drops the elbow to Michaels. In the gas.
This is almost over.
Shawn Michaels is taking it to Tatanka. We're going to have to take this commercial break. We'll be right back as the action continues. We're back with more WWF action. Shawn Michaels continues his domination over Tatanka.
Boy, domination is the right word. That's the first time he's been to his feet in 5 minutes, I think.
Tatanka, off the rope.
Look at that maneuver.
That came from left field.
Oh, elbow right in the back of the head. And the cover, one, two, and no. Shawn Michaels with a near fall on Tatanka. Measures him. Standing drop kick right in the kisser.
That was pretty.
Just seems to me Michaels is not moving in, though. He's not following up.
You don't have to follow up a move like that. That'll change those early American looks of his. You know, he already looked like a buffalo anyway.
Tatanka's in such great shape. Maybe Shawn Michaels is punching himself out. Total domination could be his downfall.
Both competitors in great condition. Proponents of integrated conditioning program. Look at this. Series of lefts and rights. Come on, ref. Get in there. The name on the marquee is wrestling, not boxing. A snap there again. And once again, Shawn Michaels beginning to dominate the matchup, setting the tempo.
Listen, do the people feel the electricity? Tatanka, yeah, come on. Let's see what you got right here. Opportunity knocks. You've got to be ready to go through that door.
Yeah. And again, a victory by Tatanka would perhaps put him in a spot of contention, perhaps even number one for the title, if he could pull it out. Tatanka, oh, ducking that clothesline. Tatanka over the head, trying to get it down.
Smart move for the young guy.
Wait a minute, not a bad time. Yes, he got it.
No, he didn't, almost.
What a maneuver and a part of Tatanka. And now, again, more desperation tactics by Michaels. And Tatanka, summoning the gods, summoning the spirit. Tatanka with momentum now. Michaels right ahead of him, chopped out of the canvas. Tatanka with a war crowd off the rope, another hard chop. Tatanka with unbelievable momentum now, and yes,
down by Bart.
Break in the face. I thought for sure Tatanka was going to get Michaels across the back.
That could be the turning point of the match right there.
You guys kill me. This guy's not the Intercontinental Champion for nothing.
Oh, no, look at that. He misses with a kick. Tatanka misses with a chop. Up goes Tatanka. Tatanka behind him.
Yeah. He got him.
No. Hook the leg. One, two. Yeah.
He got him. There's a three right there. Montana, but Tatanka got the victory.
Tatanka is still undefeated.
This place is exploding right now.
What a competitor. Tatanka, what a matchup. Tatanka and Michaels kicking things out here.
Tatanka, you deserve it all the way, dig it.
Let's take you back down to footage. Well, it's just about that time. The mirror's in the ring, and I'm sure he's all
plumped up and ready to make his debut here on WWF Superstars. Many of you saw the Narcissus unveiled at the Royal Rumble.
Once he takes this cape off, unquestionably you will see, as we all saw at the Royal Rumble, an unbelievable physique. If only he was not so impressed with himself. Although, King, you've always had that problem as well.
No, it's certainly not a problem. You see, this man loves to stand in front of the mirror for hours at a time and just gaze at himself. You see, Macho Man, if you did that, you wouldn't be a narcissist. You'd be a masochist. But this man here, he has a... Look at
that
body.
Wait a minute now. He's not a masochist. He's a machoist. There's a big difference, okay?
Jay,
if he had to look at himself in a mirror, he'd be a masochist.
Look at that. Just talk English. So everybody could understand.
Look at that.
He is really put together. No question of that.
I control.
Tremendous physique. If only Luger knew that he looked so good, huh?
Slack out there.
Come on, let's get the wrestling going. Let's see what he can do in combat. I mean, this is not a physique contest, Macho Man.
Yeah, he could be number one, but I think that he's gonna really be in a bad situation. King, if it was a physique contest, what number would you be?
About that. Gaze at that man right there. Just take a look at the... You talk about perfect. There's the perfect body.
Great symmetry, great definition, obvious huge proportions in terms of muscle mass. And unfortunately, they're taking the mirror away from Mr. Luger. Well, just one last look, if you don't mind, please.
Exactly.
Okay, boys, you can take it out.
This would be a perfect time for a schoolboy trip and a 1-2-3 count on the narcissist.
He really is impressed with himself.
Absolutely perfect.
But not perfect.
This is what a wrestler is supposed to do.
You hear that, Macho Man?
Well, yeah, but can he wrestle? I mean, let's see what he can do against the competitors here in the World Wrestling Federation. Well, there's an obvious display of power.
That's right.
Very impressive, but no follow-up.
Look at that upper body. Look at those legs. Look at those legs. Have you seen Mr. Perfect's legs? Huh? I've seen better legs on a kitchen table than he's got. There's a set of legs for you right there.
Well, maybe after the match you can get a date, King.
Ooh, my goodness. Knee lift. And Mr. Luger is unquestionably asserting himself. Not only as far as his appearance is concerned, but... obviously, as to what he can do in the square circle. And suplex with ease. You see the way he snapped his neck? Luger, double bicep again.
Oh.
A little flexing in the pecs. 275 pounds. I would say his percentage of fat is certainly in the single digits. Somewhere down around 5 points, in fact. Power slam. Oh, come on. I think we've seen enough of this, though. Still to come, an 8-foot giant Gonzalez against three competitors. We'll see. Oh, the juicy back. Holy Toledo.
Very vicious.
Good night, nurse.
He's not moving either. Not even moving.
Now, what are you guys saying?
Well,
I'd like to say that Mr. Perfect is probably watching him right now. Might be the most vicious clothesline I've ever seen.
It was more of a Luger looking at himself. Yeah, perfection, huh?
Brutus the Barber Beefcake, one of the all-time World Wrestling Federation greats. Recently, in an interview on Monday Night Raw, Brutus Beefcake told us a tale of woe that was almost unbelievable. Events that actually led up to that devastating and near-fatal parasailing accident. Your mom, just prior to that accident, you lost her to cancer after a lengthy battle with that dreaded disease. 6 months later, grief-stricken, you lose your dad to a heart attack. Again, prior to the accident, you turned then to the only family you had at the time, your wife. You're greeted with divorce papers. You take a walk on the beach to find out why. Why is all this happening to you? There on the beach, you're greeted with a parasailing accident with a set of knees from a young lady, completely devastating your face. The medevac copter comes down, picks you up. You hear what they're saying about you on the way to the hospital. You're not going to make it. In the hospital itself, you hear the doctors talking. You stated before that you felt like completely giving up until you prayed for a miracle. You also said on an interview, Brutus Beefcake, that there were two reasons that pulled you through the operation, the reconstruction of your face. Those same two reasons are with you today. They've been with you for the last 2 years as you've been training. And I suspect those two reasons will be with you this Monday night when you step into the ring against Ted DiBiase in what could be the ultimate comeback attempt. Those two reasons are...
Those two reasons are the big man upstairs, Vince, and the Hulkster. They're like my sword and my shield.
Seems to me, Brutus, that this Monday night, you're going to need all the help you can get. I don't really know if you know what you're getting into. If you would recall, on the night you issued the open invitation and Money Incorporated, they didn't fight over you, but they flipped a coin over which one was going to have the privilege of the, quote, recreation they were going to have with you. And notwithstanding Jimmy Hart's views that this match should not take place, Ted DiBiase not only is looking forward to this recreation, you heard what he said. He said that if they had to hurt you, they know how, and that they would take away the only thing that you fought so hard to regain, your health, your well-being. That has to be on your mind as you approach the match, untested as of yet, this Monday night.
You know, Vince, their overconfidence is their downfall, because with the big man on one side, the Hulkster on the other side, that's a team that DiBiase and IRS can't beat.
All I can say is, Brutus, with that kind of inspiration, the best of luck to you this Monday night.
Thanks, Vince.
As the Hulkster said, go for it.
We're back with more WWF action. And Brutus the Barber Beefcake is back this Monday, meeting the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase.
Well, I tip my hat to Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Good luck. He wants me to back out of it. He wants to do it on his own. Go for it, like Hulk Hogan said.
Dan Farron and Louis Spicoli.
All right, now we have three individuals.
And there
we're going to meet this man.
Accompanied by Harvey Whippleman, standing nearly 8 feet tall. Here is the giant Gonzalez.
That's who you better be tipping that silly looking head of yours to right there.
I have never seen a human being with proportions like giant Gonzalez. 8 feet, somewhere around the 400-pound mark. He's huge, massive. And everyone saw the damage he did to The Undertaker at the Royal Rumble. No man has ever manhandled The Undertaker like Giant Gonzalez did.
Which has never been done before. The Undertaker went down, but Las Vegas, WrestleMania 9, that man right there, The Undertaker, is going to get a second chance against this Giant Gonzalez heel.
And that one will be a one-on-one, I must say. And you can bet between now and April, The Undertaker will have his strategy down. But what kind of strategy could you have against an 8-foot giant? What do you do?
Well, I'll tell you what you do. You do what these three guys are doing. You try to figure a way out of the match. Try to put somebody else in there instead of yourself. That's what you do.
Did you guys see Todd Pettengill interview the giant on WWF Mania? Pettengill looked like a midget.
Oh, look at this.
Somebody's going to come in the ring, whether they want to or not. Spicoli. Look at the giant. Boy, he sure likes what he does, huh? Look at this. The giant reached right out and grabbed Spicoli. Caught him in the ring. The other two individuals very, very reticent to get near the giant. Come on, Russ, get in there.
His face is redder than Tatanka's hair right now.
Nobody wants to get near this guy.
The official intimidated by this 8-foot giant Gonzalez.
Well, if The Undertaker's intimidated by him, don't you expect the official to be?
The Undertaker is not intimidated by him. He got the jump on him in that Royal Rumble. We're going to see what happens in Las Vegas at WrestleMania 9.
The last time I saw The Undertaker, this is the same thing that was happening.
Oh, my. Here comes Gonzalez.
Yeah, quick he moves. See how quick they're moving.
And wait a minute, they're just leaving the park for Spicoli. Spicoli rolled out. He takes off, and look at the smile on Harvey Whippleman's face. Harvey Whippleman representing the 8-foot giant Gonzalez, who will square out one-on-one against The Undertaker at Caesar's Palace. Boom, wow, what a matchup that's going to be.
I'll tell you, I think I'd rather have gotten beat 1-2-3 in the ring than run out of the arena, but that's their choice right there.
Take a look at that awesome physical specimen. Let's take you now to the event center.
Say some big man, anytime, any place.
Well then, why not right here next week?
Let me tell you, next week won't come quick enough for the quake.
To do when he gets in that ring.
Well, maybe he'll get a few more gold chains for Valentine's Day, right? Coming up very shortly.
I can't wait to see the gifts I'm gonna get.
You're gonna get nothing.
Oh, I get showered with gifts on Valentine's Day.
I like to shower.
Everybody loves me. I'm sure Razor Ramon will get his share. Yeah, oozing machismo.
The bad guy, Razor Ramon, showed me some tremendous wrestling skills at the Royal Rumble.
He was a victim of some very shady, shoddy refereeing.
Please. Oh, tremendous ovation for Typhoon.
Now, this is very interesting. I want to see how he's going to do without having to rely on his partner, Earthquake. He hasn't been in single competition for quite some time, and that kind of takes the edge off a tag team wrestler. Razor Ramon, he's been a single all his life.
Hey, Brain, when Typhoon came here to the World Wrestling Federation, did he have a tag partner?
No.
He came here as a single.
I know, but lately he's been wrestling in tags. You learn how to depend on somebody, how to mooch off your partner. Well,
I'm going to be interested to see how Mr. Machismo deals with this tremendous weight differential. He could get squashed like a grape. Whoa! Excuse me.
You gotta get Typhoon down. You can't get up and match strength with him one-on-one.
Because Razor's pretty strong, too, you know.
What a power display. Hey, take a look. Take a look, Brain. It's Mr. Pussy.
What's he doing?
Obviously,
keep him away from me.
He's out here to take a look. The feud between Mr. Perfect and Razor Ramon, Brain, a long way from being over.
Why is he out here? He doesn't belong out here. He should be back in the dressing room hiding.
Hiding?
Yes, like the yellow coward he is.
Well, I'm not too sure that Razor has even spotted Perfect yet, but imagine the distraction of having your number one nemesis looking over your shoulder when you have to look into the face of a guy like Ray, like a Typhoon. What a disadvantage.
Of course it's a disadvantage. The official should make Mr. Perfect go back to the dressing room area.
You're not bothering anybody.
You want me? Hold my hands. I'll run him back.
I can call him over.
Don't do that. I got to call him.
Hey, Perfect.
Hey, shut up.
Got a pal of yours here.
Hey, will you watch the match?
What do you think, Ray? Oh, now he spotted him.
Sure, the humanoids are chanting Perfect. Perfect. Concentrate on Typhoon.
That's got to be for Razor Ramon.
But you know what I like? He didn't give him a second look. He ignored Mr. Perfect. He's got a job to do. He's got to get a victory over this 400-pound goof, Typhoon. He can't worry about Mr. Perfect, and he's not. But he's sure worried about Razor Ramon, isn't he?
The mark of a true professional, Razor Ramon, showing us what he's made of.
Keep him down. Keep him down.
You know, he could have just walked right out of here, Brain. And rightfully so.
That's right. But he knows Perfect's not coming down to ringside. The last thing Perfect wants to do is to get his hands on Razor Ramon. Because if you put your hands on Razor Ramon, he eventually gets his hands on you.
Razor now starting to unload here on Typhoon, who's taking an awful lot of punishment.
Come on, Razor, kick him, punch him. Just a big 300-pound Cuban sandwich.
If we don't get some kind of offense out of Typhoon, this one won't last much longer.
I think Typhoon's out of gas. He's looking for the Shell Answer Man.
Oh, nice reversal.
Oh.
Followed him right in with a clothesline.
Get out of that corner, Razor.
A peel out of the corner. Whoa. He was airborne.
You bet. Still standing here. What is he doing?
There's another chair here.
Don't bring him over here.
I could have him come over.
He hasn't taken his eyes off that ring.
Avalanche in the corner.
No, Razor, get up. Get up. Uh-oh.
Look out, Razor. Below.
Yes. Yes, good move.
Right at the last split second, Razor out of there. Obviously, playing a little possum brain.
Oh, he's not going to get him up for the Razor's edge. Hook him here. Cut his arrow.
He's got him.
Yes. With Mr. Perfect watching, he still kept his mind on what he had to do. And that was defeat Typhoon.
Well, I think that Razor Ramon can consider himself very fortunate here, Brain.
Of course. Wrestling a man as big and with the reputation of Typhoon, and with Mr. Perfect watching on, he had a lot of distractions, a lot going against him.
Uh-oh. Right now he's turning his attention to Mr. Perfect.
Sure, you're up there, Perfect. You don't have the guts to come down the ringside.
He said, what do you want? He wants a piece of you.
Perfect has not taken his eyes off Ramon. You better never.
Yo. Oyeme, chico. You come out here to get a look at Razor Ramon? Huh? Well, hey, you little smurf.
Hey, smurf!
You want to look at the bad guy? Why don't you come right down here?
Well, you won't have to ask him twice.
He's thinking it over. Now, in front of all these people, he wants to go back. He wants to go to the wrestling room, but he's got to save face.
He's going to ringside
and get his tail kicked.
if he gets that close.
Batten down the hatches.
Come down here, man.
You better get some security
I
out here.
Real good look.
Frazier's gonna hurt him.
One man in the WWF who is oozing machismo.
Well, right now he's oozing perspiration.
Well, he had a tough match. Perfect's a cheap shot artist.
Quiet.
You want some of me? You want some of me? Listen.
Watch him, Perfect.
Oh!
Right across the kitchen.
Here we go. Here we go.
Oh. Steel chair into the ribcage.
Oh, your ribs hurt, Mr. Perfecto. Slap him around.
You better get the job done, Razor. Don't let Perfect get to his feet.
Perfect's got a temper, I know. He gets going, there's going to be trouble out here. But Razor's got a bigger temper, and he's got an ego, and he's got pride. Come on, Razor.
Oh, look at this. Razor's running.
Come on, Razor.
Razor wants out of there.
Looks like the referees don't even want to get involved.
Perfect has lost control.
Kick him, Razor, kick him. Get up to your feet.
A lot of guys down there, but nobody is going to stop these two.
Would you want to step in between those two? Come on, Perfect. Come on, Perfect. Get the dressing room before Razor turns your head off.
Boy,
come on, Perfect.
Right,
let's see what you got. Let's see what you got, Perfect.
Oh, Razor's down. Shot. They're both down.
Come on, Razor.
Hey, we got to get out of here.
Hold
we'll
on,
be
Razor.
Right back.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Last week, you fought out like everyone when facing my Yokozuna. Not only did he defeat you, but he squash you.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
You see, this is going to be the greatest time of our life to take those belts off of my knee. So get ready. Next week, it's going to happen. Whoa,
that's
it's
right.
Going to happen,
baby. Birdman, our dream has finally come
true. Yes!
We got a shot at the World Tag Team Championship.
Yes!
And High Energy has been climbing that ladder day in and day out.
Yes!
Each day, we step one step closer. And now we got you, Money, Inc. We're going to be the new Tag Team Champions. You mark my words.
High Energy's got their chance at the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team titles. They've been doing a lot of dancing. Well, right here next week, you're going to find out if you dance, you got to pay the fiddler.
And there's only one thing worse than paying the fiddler. That's paying Money Incorporated.
Bam! Bam!
Yeah. Bad! Bam!
The big men in the World Wrestling Federation, they get bigger and better with every single day. Bam, bam, against the earthquake. Pick a macho man. Who's going to take it?
I'm on the edge of my seat. I just want to sit back and
bam,
watch this.
Bam.
Well, I'll pick it.
All right, pick it.
Bam. How can you go against that man right there? Huh?
Bam. Wait a minute. What about the credentials of yes? There's a rumbling here in the
wait
building.
A minute. Wait a minute.
The Battle of the Bohemians, Earthquake and Bat. Look at this. My goodness. Wow.
Check the look on Bam Bam's face right there.
Yeah, he doesn't seem to be intimidated at all by Earthquake.
Lost
and
a little
vice
bit of
versa.
A spark.
Each individual looking at the other. A kick to the chops there. And, no one goes anywhere. Bam Bam hits the rope again and ducking down. Another. Look at that.
Wow. Gonna change your bet, King.
No, I'm still not changing yet. I didn't realize there was quite that much size difference. Earthquake is actually bigger than Bam Bam.
Yes, he is. No one, speaking of big men, however, no one is any bigger than Yokozuna. Look at this! Yes! I like everybody earthquake!
Welcome to the ground, Bam Bam.
And he may stay down there. Earthquake all over Bam Bam. And the big man matchup.
Hard right hand. Oh, my goodness.
When these big boys throw a punch, they can drive you through the mat.
What about the Ike Pro situation here, Vince McMahon? What do you think?
There's all kinds of... Wait a minute.
No.
Look at
oh,
this.
Man.
And the slam.
Never seen that before on Bam Bam Bigelow.
He did it with ease, too.
Earthquake.
Uh-oh.
Dropping the elbow and missing. Bam Bam Bigelow now with a shot to do something in his own right.
Use that head, Bam Bam. Use that head.
Uh-oh. And no way.
Yes, yes. Look at that suplex by Bam Bam.
Incredible.
That was very, very impressive.
I cannot believe I've seen the earthquake inside suplex right to the back of his neck like that. Now, can he come back from that?
If Bam Bam Bigelow gets a shot at the World Wrestling Federation title prior to WrestleMania, it could be Bam Bam facing Yokozuna at Caesar's Palace.
I'd put my money on that.
Tell you what, Bam Bam Bigelow is showing endurance right now.
Right of a chin lock here, Bam Bam Bigelow pouring it on. You can bet he's taking all of his 400 pounds and pressing down on the earthquake as well, trying to cut the wind right out of him.
Bam Bam got off to a slow start, but now he's got the momentum back. Unbelievable.
And again, crushing forearm by Bam Bam.
I'm just sitting here waiting for a few of those patented headbutts. I know they're coming.
I'll tell you what, King, you just better sit here with me because the competition in the World Wrestling Federation is like I've never, never seen it before.
Bam Bam Bigelow claims tattooed on his head, all over his body, and it looks like the earthquake. Yes, another shot. If you didn't believe it the first time, you saw it again.
I can't believe he hasn't blown out his lower back doing that earthquake.
Bam Bam Bigelow messing with a headbutt.
On the Richter scale.
And now the earthquake with a kick to the ribs, the second one now. Bam Bam back to the corner. Quake with a shoulder block. And oh, look out now. Here it comes. Yes. Bam Bam lower down into the corner. Earthquake with more momentum. Another one.
Both guys are showing not only that they're big, not only that they got girth, but they're both in shape.
That was horrible.
Tell you what, that hurts a big man a lot more than it hurts a smaller guy falling that far down to the ground.
He hit his ribs and everything else coming down on those steps off the ring post. Wow, what a maneuver that was. Bam Bam dropping out of the way. Earthquake over the top to the outside. And look at that. Bam Bam gets the victory. The earthquake was counted out.
We'll be right back.
What is that?
The following contest.
It's the Macho Man. What else? He never looked better.
That's for anybody that wants to see me in the bear.
Oh, boy.
A Macho Bear. How about that?
Here
it
is. That looks more like you, Macho Man.
Star.
Give me a break. Who is that? Slick. And Reverend Slick takes very little if any, of the recognition as far as the change in temperament, the change in outlook of the mighty Kamala. According to Reverend Slick, it's the people. It's the bond between Kamala and the fans. He's never seen anything like it before. Kamala chopping away on, what's this gentleman's name? Mike Starr?
I think so. But you know, Kamala has always liked people, especially if they're properly cooked. I don't know what's come over this guy. He's not the same. He's not.
What do you mean he's not the same?
He's
certainly the same competitor. Look at this.
No, he's not. He's not vicious. He's not brutal. He's not feared like he used to be.
Oh, I don't know about that at all. I think, as a matter of fact, that if anything, Kimchi. Wait a minute, there is Kimchi. Kimchi used to handle Kamala. He used to beat Kamala. He used to order Kamala around. And you saw what happened when Kimchi put his hands on Reverend Slick. Kamala chased him out of the ring. Oh, he sees him now. He sees him. If this could be over, Reverend Slick has to stop him. But he'll forget his match. He'll forget everything. He wants to get his hands on Kimchi. If Kimchi knows what's good for him, he better get out of here.
Remember the Battle Royal on Monday Night Raw when he took off after him, away upstairs in the Manhattan Center?
He went everywhere.
Everywhere.
Right on the concession stand, upstairs in the balcony, downstairs in the dressing room. Kamala still has not caught that man right there, Kimchi. When he does, well, I don't know what's going to happen.
It'll be a salty situation, like the King said.
Top to the head. Another one. Series of them now. Kamala chopping his way on Mike Starr. Not vicious, huh? What was that remark earlier?
Well.
Yeah, well.
That's a deep subject.
And what's going to happen when Kamala gets his hands on Kimchi? Will it be the teacher continuing to teach the pupil, or vice versa?
I think the teacher's got
down, go Star.
A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
And look out!
Hey!
Wait a minute.
See if he's learned anything from Slick here. Look, everybody helping him out. Turn him over. That's it. Look at this. Look at the momentum. Everybody's giving
him. He has the legs up and...
A double hook.
Well, kind of.
He's learning. He's got him down for a count of 20, I know that. Now it's 30. 104, 105.
And the count continues.
Just remember, Kimchi taught Kamala everything he knows, but he didn't teach him everything Kimchi knows.
I see.
Which is not much. But he's gone on since then.
Ugandan giant, the mighty Kamala. In a few moments, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be taking you to the wife of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Deborah Duggan, who's very much concerned not just for the welfare, but the prospect of a return to action for her husband.
In light of what's happened, I'd just like to say that Jim and I have been together for almost 10 years. And in those years, I've nursed him back through many injuries. 4 knee operations, torn Achilles tendon, crushed vertebrae, and many other injuries. But now, everything is different. We've always wanted to have a baby, and now that I'm pregnant, Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna have done this to Jim. This could not have happened at a worse time. All I want is for Jim to be able to play with this baby. I know he's a proud man, and I know he loves his country, and I know millions of people love to watch him wrestle, but I love him, and our baby loves him. And I don't want to see him hurt. Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna have done this to Jim because he is a proud American. But we're not at war with Japan. This is a sport, and I don't want to see him hurt. I don't want Jim to wrestle. I'm sorry, but I don't want Jim to wrestle.
Hey, boss man! You're way too serious! You need to loosen up! Laugh a little bit! Because next week, you've got a date with me. It's going to be no laughing matter. Doink, you think I'm too serious? Well, you ain't seen nothing yet!
You're the kind of trash that likes to hurt people, make people sad. Well, next week, I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to make you sad, and I'm going to see how you like it, punk. So get ready to serve nothing but hard time, punk.
This young team here could walk away WWF Tag Team Champions.
Well, only because of what went down, Rain, on Raw, a lot of dissension in the ranks. Will Jimmy Hart show up here this week on Wrestling Challenge?
What do you think? He's got an investment.
I don't think so. By Rockin' Owen Hart, that Coke will beware with a golden opportunity. Well, let's take a look. I don't see the little guy.
The $1 million man.
He's not here, Brad.
Everybody, I'm sure I saw him here.
There's the $1 million man.
Incorporated. Well, unless he's on his hands and knees underneath the ring, I don't see him.
He's got to be here. Tell me no, you humanoid.
Obvious to me that Jimmy Hart is not in attendance, and I don't blame him. After that despicable display by Irwin and Ted DiBiase on Raw, you know, I said a lot of nasty things about that little runt, Jimmy Hart, but I may have to take them all back.
He may be here yet. Maybe he's on the phone. A lot of things could happen.
Well, you being the journalist, you're supposed to know all this stuff.
I'm sitting here with you. I can't be every place.
Nice shoulder block by Coco. Look out. Oh, beautiful high crossbody. Almost got him.
Look at those pants.
Well, if he's in fact not in the building, Irwin and DiBiase got to be wondering why. Well, they don't have to wonder too long.
If there was any trouble, the team would show it.
If there was any trouble? Obviously, you didn't see Raw.
I saw Raw.
Well, then you know what the situation is. Irish whip by DiBiase. No, reversal. A little bit late. Coco telegraphed that move a little bit.
Coco's got a quick cut in his hair with that circular saw.
You know, he might have just dislocated that patella. That's your kneecap, Ray.
I know. I was just going to say that to the people.
Limped out of there, made a tag in a hurry to the Rocket. Look at these quick moves.
You know, and that's bad, too, because their whole arsenal, their whole offense is aerial moves.
Coco trying to shake it loose there in the corner.
It's those big baggy pants. That's what did it. This team seems to be going quite well. Money Incorporated seems to be got all their moves down. They got all their timing down.
Hey, they're a great team. They're the champions. But without the brains of Jimmy Hart, no telling for how long.
I'm sure I saw him here.
The Rocket, Owen Hart, the younger brother of WWF champion Bret the Hitman Hart. What a strong wrestling family. Irwin in trouble here with his arm wringer.
Is Coco still favoring that knee?
Well, he was rubbing on it a minute ago.
Oh, he's back in.
He's on that second turnbuckle on the inside.
Uh-oh, see? Well,
he come down with a little bit of weight on it. He couldn't really support it.
He's not 100%. The way he walks around in those yellow and checkered pants limping. It looks like a cab with a flat tire.
How about the shot that Irwin gave to the Brutus the Barber Beefcake?
Oh, yeah.
Trying to take his head apart.
A knee just went out on him. Boy, Money Incorporated have done a lot of damage in the last couple of weeks.
Uh-oh, it looks like this is going to be a handicap match, Frank.
Well, you know, Coco's known to be a quitter.
He is not.
I remember when I wrestled, I would just tape it up and gut it out and get back in.
You don't know the meaning of the word. Gut it out.
Sometimes I wouldn't even tape it up. I'd say, just let me in there. Let me get my hands on him. That's a competitor.
Well, we'll get to see right here as a couple of additional referees have gone down to ringside, perhaps to help Coco back to get some medical assistance here.
I know exactly what to do, but they won't do it.
Take him back and get him an x-ray.
You take him to a taxidermist and have him stuffed.
Oh, please.
What you do with all wounded birds.
In the meantime, the Rocket is getting an education from Money, Inc.
I don't care if his brother is the WWF champion. I don't care if he comes from a wrestling family. There's nothing Owen Hart's going to do in that ring against two veterans and competitors and the tag team champions like DiBiase and IRS. See, they don't need Jimmy. Everything's okay.
Unfortunately, Brain, I'll have to agree with you. I don't like Owen's chances against these two ring veterans, these two tremendous ring technicians.
As long as they keep making legal tags.
Look at this.
They got a count of five to get out of the ring.
Referee warning him here.
Let's see how much heart you have, Owen.
Don't worry, he's got plenty of heart.
And I can see it pounding through his chest. He's had it.
Wouldn't surprise me to see Coco come back. It's happened before. Oh, look at that.
No, Coco's a quitter.
He just jerked him up by the hair.
Well, they're not done with him yet. I believe they're sending a message to his older brother. Everyone would like a shot at the Hitman. Double suplex.
Referee allowing this double teaming to go on.
Oh, they're not done yet.
He jerked him up again.
Still time for school.
Well, the referee could stop this match at any point, Brain.
Yeah, well, they're doing everything legal.
It's not legal to pull a guy's hair up when it's possible to get a three count.
Now, you don't know. Maybe Owen hooked his hair around.
Let's see what happens here. He jerked him up again.
I couldn't tell. It looked like he kicked out.
Oh, the referee's ringing the bell. And the Hitman's coming down.
Oh, this is going to be interesting.
Brett has seen enough. Coming to the aid of his younger brother.
You know, that's very unusual for the WWF champion to get involved in any kind of situation like this. But this is family, right?
This is blood.
Is blood thicker than water?
You bet.
Maybe we'll see some.
The winners of the match by disqualification, High Energy.
Well, High Energy gets the victory here by disqualification. The title, of course, does not change hands. Only on pinfall or submission. Well, Bret the Hitman Hart coming to the aid of younger brother Owen as we take you to our special report. Well, Brain, the narcissist Lex Luger headed for Las Vegas, Nevada. A lot of mirrors
intruding
are at Caesars.
Boy, he's going to love it there. And he's going to love taking Mr. Perfect apart.
I don't think he's going to be too thrilled about that.
Look at him. Is he something, Monsoon? Is he put together? Beautiful music.
Nobody ever denied that, Frank. Guy's got a tremendous body. But, hey, enough is enough.
No, you can never get enough of the narcissist, Lex Luger. The ladies are out in droves.
Maybe he won't look so pretty after April 4th.
That is just your opinion.
That's true. He's never faced anybody like Mr. Perfect, has he?
But he's above perfection. Oh, he has his mirror. Look at this.
Oh, boy.
Look, he's teasing himself. A peek here, a peek there.
Come on, let's get some of our guys. Let's get that mirror out of there. Get this match.
Get your heart out, Bimbo.
I want to see this match.
Look at that specimen. Is he put together?
Come on, get the hook.
Does he love himself, Monsoon? And does he have a right?
What does he think this is? The Luger Hour? Challenge.
That's fine. He's blowing kisses at himself. He's not done yet.
Oh, please. You gotta
break.
No, we're not going.
We're going to have to go to a commercial
no,
break.
We're not going anywhere.
This guy used up all of our time.
I'm call the director. I'm a
we're going to go to a commercial. We'll be right back. Can we get started now?
Quiet. Enjoy this.
Enjoy this?
You'll never enjoy it as much as Lex is.
Don't you ever cut to a commercial.
Well, I guess then we'll never get to a commercial.
Just a minute.
He never stops closing.
Hey, dummy. Dummy. Talking to our director.
Don't ever cut the commercial when Lex Luger is closing. You got it? You know something, Brain? At Caesar's Palace, WrestleMania 9, Las Vegas, Nevada, Mr. Perfect will defeat the narcissist Lex Luger. And I'll tell you why, Brain. Because he's not going to be able to get any sleep. You know, at Caesars, they have those mirrors on the ceiling.
That's right.
In your bedroom.
That's right.
And he'll be wide-eyed all night just looking at himself.
But think how happy he'll be.
Yeah.
He'll be able to see more of himself than he's ever seen. He'll be able to see himself when he's awake. He'll be able to see himself when he's sleeping, when he's taking a nap. He'll be the happiest guy at Caesars. Perfect will go like that.
He'll be hard-pressed right here to get by Virgil. This is his toughest competition since his inception here in the WWF.
And what a treat. How lucky you people are at home and you people here in the building to see the debut of the narcissist Lex Luger in your homes live. I mean, what a treat.
Why don't you just relax? Oh, nice move by Verge. Whoa.
Yes, he did go down quick.
Steamroll him. What a shot that was by Luger.
Look, it almost took his head off.
He just knocked him out, Brain.
Virgil has no idea where he's at.
Verge is not moving. He's not cold.
Watch this, the little finger. One, two, three.
Is that something? Is that something?
Yes. Yes. He knocked Virgil out. Scores a knockout here on Virgil. Look at Virgil, can't even sit up. Why is he trying to sit him up? The guy is unconscious.
He's sending a message to the world that Virgil is out cold.
Gonna pick him up here in a Paul Nelson.
No, he's gonna break his neck, I think.
Why would you put somebody on their feet that's unconscious?
Gonna take him for a ride.
I don't like his attitude.
I've never seen Virgil get knocked out like that. I've never seen Virgil knocked out.
There is even a mirror there. He's still
trying. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself. Look at the chest. Look at the bicep. Look at that neck. Look at that. Most powerful. Oh.
Let's go back and take a look at what went down earlier on in this one.
Yes, let's see more of this, please. Look at this, Monsoon. Look at this clothesline. Virgil doesn't know where he is at this point.
Run that again. Here we come.
Run that again. I'd like to see more of Lex. Hello?
Hulk Hogan, the entire world awaits for your announcement this Monday night on Monday Night Raw. Hulkamaniacs, young and old alike, hoping that you will say what they want you to say, that you're going to return to the ring in the World Wrestling Federation. It was right here in this very studio approximately a year ago, prior to WrestleMania last year, that you and I speculated on the future of Hulkamania. That speculation continues. Just what is, in your mind, the future of Hulkamania?
Well, I tell you, Mr. McMahon, the future of Hulkamania is so exciting, I really don't know how to express myself. But all I know is sitting back for the last year and watching all my Hulkamaniacs, little and big, continue to train, say their prayers, eat their vitamins, and believe in themselves, makes me realize that those people just aren't my friends, those Hulkamaniacs. Those people that have carried on even without me have turned into my heroes instead of my friends, because those are the ones that believe, those are the ones that live the positive lifestyle, and those are the ones that continue to set examples for the rest of the world. And the future of Hulkamania is really bright, and I can't wait to get into that. But before I do, I'd like to talk about the past of Hulkamania. You know, when you're at the top of any field, any chosen profession, whether it be business, whether it be entertainment, whether it be sports, or whether it's sports entertainment like Hulk Hogan was at the top of for so many years, there are a lot of curious people that want to dig into your past and find out what you're all about. Mm-hmm. Well, when they dug into Hulk Hogan's past, they found out big surprise, Hulk Hogan is a human being. And as they looked into my past, even from Little League, Hulk Hogan is not afraid to admit he's made mistakes. On a personal level, I've made mistakes. On a business level, I don't always make the right decisions. And even on a peer pressure level, as I was growing up through the 60s, 70s, and 80s, I made mistakes too. And my father even said, son, don't do as I do as I say. Well, I want to change that around now, because the future of Hulkamania is so positive. I want all those Hulkamaniacs to know that stuck with me, and stuck with me for the last year, even when I wasn't around, that we're going to another level. And then there's always the negative side. We're in the era of the 90s, and notwithstanding the legitimate media, there's a lot of tabloid terrorism going out there. Everybody knows about that. These are the people that dwell in the negatives, dig up any dirt they can, and even if the allegations are false, they report them anyway, and they don't care who they hurt, just as long as they personally gain from it. But thank God, the Hulkamaniacs are not all about that. We dwell on the positives, not the negatives. And the Hulkamaniacs know with a positive lifestyle, setting your goals high, and with positive work ethics, you can have anything you want in this life. And also, Vince McMahon, the Hulkamaniacs, the big ones and the little ones, know that the future of America lies in our youth. That's why Hulk Hogan wants to be the leader of the 90s. And now, it's not just do as I say, it's also do as I do, Vince McMahon, because there's a new demandment. There's five of them now for my Hulkamaniacs, and they go just like this. Train, say your prayers, eat your vitamins, believe in yourself, and believe in Hulk Hogan. And wait till my Hulkamaniacs hear what I have to say on Monday Night Raw.
I can't wait.
We are just about underway with this WWF Mania exclusive match. You may believe you recognize that individual under the mask. Can we reveal his identity? It's Repo Man.
It is Repo Man indeed.
What is with this new garb he's sporting?
Well, I think he feels more comfortable with that mask.
Really?
I rather like the other thing he had, those Lone Ranger-type things he wore around his eyes.
Well, the tire treads are missing, but looks like that outfit was run over by a big truck one or two times.
It certainly does, indeed.
Mike Starr may feel like he was flattened by a Mack before this battle is over. And Lord Alfred Hayes, you mentioned you had some inside information for me today.
I did indeed. I have heard, and I really have this on almost the proper authority, that there will be a reward of $10,000 given to any World Wrestling Federation superstar who can rip the mask.
A $10,000 reward?
That new mask. If they can get that new mask.
Boy, that is
of his head.
That is a very bold challenge. You said almost the proper authority. What does that
almost.
Mean?
Well,
how valuable is that?
From me, extremely valuable. You should know that.
Head scissor now being applied to Mike Starr's head. And, that has not got to feel very good. You know what I mean?
I would think that would give you a terrible, terrible headache.
Well, how about a stomachache right there? A shot to the sternum. Drop toe hold as Repo Man, not in a very good mood today.
He's not in a very good mood, but he is giving this fellow, Mike Starr, a wrestling lesson.
Now, has there been any takers to this opportunity to strip him of his mask? I mean, a lot of superstars would like to get $10,000.
They certainly would, and I believe that every one of them is now looking out to get this $10,000 for merely plucking the mask off of that fellow, Repo Man. I say merely because can you imagine the temerity of somebody who would attempt to do such a thing?
No. Who could it be? At Lord Alfred Hayes, a beautiful day here in Long Beach, California. Let you know what's on my mind. Las Vegas, Nevada.
Another beautiful place.
Sunday, April 4th, WrestleMania will erupt. Perhaps the biggest news this week, Hulk Hogan back in the World Wrestling Federation. And what do you think about his announcement? The Mega Maniacs is going to join forces with Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
That's a tremendous announcement, especially at the moment the Repo Man wins that match. I cannot wait to see that duo in action.
Repo Man makes quick work of Mike Starr. But Alfred Hayes, I know you're impressed with the new and improved Repo Man. No doubt about it. Thanks, Todd. And as you can see, joining me today here on WWF Mania is a very special guest, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. And first of all, Jimmy, I want to say congratulations on becoming the manager of the Mega Maniacs.
Well, you know, first of all, I'd just like to congratulate myself, baby. This is definitely the greatest day of my life. You know, Sean, I'm so excited. I don't know whether to just hug you or shake your hand, man. I think I'm just going to shake your hand, okay?
Well, that's good enough for me, Jimmy. And it is now official. You are the manager of the Mega Maniacs. A lot of people want to know. They want the inside scoop. How did it all come together? How did you really get together with Brutus and the Hulkster?
Well, you know what all started on Monday Night Raw, man. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, he was making his return to the World Wrestling Federation. A couple of guys that I managed at that time, Irwin R. Scheister, Ted DiBiase, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Money Incorporated, took it on themselves to smash this guy's face in with a metal briefcase. Brutus was laying there, and I just had to do what Jimmy Hart had to do. I dove across his body. It was just the right thing to do, man.
It certainly was, and I know shortly after that, you got a call from Hulk Hogan.
Oh, man, I was sitting at home. The phone rang. It was the man in the red and yellow, and he goes, "Hey, dude, I saw what you did, man." It was Hulk Hogan himself, and the rest is history, man.
Well, they plan to make history as the Mega Maniacs, and we heard Hulk Hogan this past week on Monday Night Raw. He claimed his number one priority is Money Incorporated. A lot of bad feelings right now between you and your former tag team. How are you going to put that together?
You know, I know everything that's happening here in the World Wrestling Federation. And one thing I know, that on Monday Night Raw, Money Incorporated will be there. And I will get that contract signed, baby.
Okay, that's coming up this week. We'll watch that situation very closely. And briefly, Jimmy Hart, tell us what it is really like to be the manager of the Mega Maniacs.
First of all,
you came prepared.
I got some merchandise for you, man. Hulk Hogan merchandise. I want you to look through all this stuff, man. I'll tell you what it is. Remember the five commandments, man. Say your prayers. Take your vitamins. Train every day. Believe in yourself. And most of all, believe in Hulk Hogan, baby. And believe in the
Mega Maniacs.
Okay. That's it, baby.
With that, let's get back to action here on Mania. The Narcissist taking on Virgil.
When you're the World Wrestling Federation champion, it's your job to study your opponents. And that's what I've done. I've studied Yokozuna, and I've watched him come into the World Wrestling Federation and wipe out every single guy he stepped in the ring with. He's wiped them all out. He's squashed them all. He's undefeated. And you know something? The World Wrestling Federation champion, the Hitman, respects that. But when you turn it around the other way, Yokozuna and Mr. Fuji, they have no respect for me. They don't respect where I've come from. They don't respect my wrestling ability. They don't respect the fact that I am the excellence of execution and I am the World Wrestling Federation champion. But mark my words, I kind of like the fact, Mr. Fuji, that I'm going into WrestleMania 9 as the underdog. But remember one thing, you will walk out of the ring respecting me, and I will walk out of the ring wearing the World Wrestling Federation championship belt.
I told everybody in the World Wrestling Federation that I had a big bomb in store. Well, as you can see, I have unveiled the big bomb. And unfortunately for you, Undertaker, he's going to explode right on you in Caesar's Palace at WrestleMania. So you better make your final plans. Isn't that right, Giant Gonzalez?
Undertaker, you will rest in peace.
I'm standing here today at Akaka Falls, one of the many, many places my grandfather used to bring me when I was growing up. Akaka Falls is not only, as you can see, a very beautiful place, but a person can come here and feel peace within himself and feel very, very close to nature. Reflecting back on my grandfather, whose profession was being a clown, he enjoyed his job mostly because seeing children laugh, watching people have a good time, these were like his biggest rewards. But you, Doink, you get off on hurting people. You get off on seeing people being miserable. You get off on seeing kids cry. Well, WrestleMania 9, you've got to step into the ring with me, brother. And I will not only avenge myself for what you did to me, the concussion you gave me, which almost ended my career, but I also avenge all the kids who you've made cry, who you've made miserable. Brother, I'm going to make your life at WrestleMania 9 10 times as miserable.
This week, Doink, you will be facing a man that won't have to put up with your silly practical jokes, and I am speaking of the Big Boss Man.
Well, he might not have much choice because I got a big surprise for the Big Boss Man. Oh, no, let me rephrase that. The law and order of the WWF, that is the joke. let me show you this trick I know. Let me show you this trick. Watch the hanky. Watch the hanky.
Standing by with us now, ladies and gentlemen, the father of Hacksaw Jim Duggan, former chief of police of Glens Falls, New York. Chief Duggan, are you there?
Yes, I am, Mr. McMahon.
Mr. Duggan, could you give us a condition report on your son, Jim?
Well, Jim's ribs are pretty bad right now, and he's pretty distraught. He feels like he let his family and his friends, and especially his country, down.
Well, do you feel like he let anyone down, sir?
Heck no. Jim wouldn't let us down.
Well, indeed, as far as I'm concerned, I'm sure you would concur. He did what he said he wanted to do. He knocked Yokozuna off his feet.
Yes, that's my boy. He sure did.
What about returning to the ring, sir? Would you encourage Jim Duggan to return to the ring?
Without a doubt. The sooner the better.
I see.
As far as I'm concerned, Mr. McMahon, nobody carries the banner of the red, white, and blue like my son Jim. I'm damn proud of him.
Well, thank you very much for joining us, Chief Duggan from Glens Falls, New York.
All right, folks, we all watched the Royal Rumble and couldn't believe our eyes when out of nowhere, this near 8-foot specimen literally manhandled The Undertaker, something that no man has been able to do. Keeping that in mind, let me call out Harvey Whippleman and the Giant Gonzalez.
My goodness. Look at this. He is a specimen, an awesome specimen. And everyone recalls very vividly the way that Giant Gonzalez manhandled The Undertaker on that one occasion. Could it happen again at WrestleMania?
A scary thought that was, and it was reality during the Rumble. He did it to The Undertaker, but will he do it at Caesar's Palace?
Harvey Whippleman, what gave you the right to interfere in the Royal Rumble match and have your Giant Gonzalez attack The Undertaker?
Mr. Russo, The Undertaker ruined my business relationship with the once mighty Kamala because when he put him into the coffin at the Survivor Series, Kamala had never been the same since. Now then, I feel like it is only fitting that The Undertaker will never be the same after what the Giant Gonzalez done to him at the Royal Rumble.
With all due respect, I firmly believe that when The Undertaker steps into the ring with your Giant Gonzalez, he will cut him down to size.
Give The Undertaker credit. He is truly a big man. But this is a giant. And when he puts his giant hands on The Undertaker once again, The Undertaker will see a giant defeat. A giant humiliation. And a giant funeral.
What a matchup headed to WrestleMania! The 8-foot Giant Gonzalez against The Undertaker.
Thank you very much, Vince McMahon. Tremendous to be here on the WWF Superstars. Tremendous ovation for the Big Boss Man. The law and order of the WWF. What's he got in the box, Frame?
I don't know.
You're the journalist. You're supposed to know everything.
But it's not my box. It's his box.
Don't trust him, Boss Man.
Give him a present.
Look at that. Before the bell even rang.
May have been a cinder block in there. Who knows?
What a job he did! Oh, neckbreaker, well executed.
Well, he hurt the boss man.
By Doink.
See, you're usually going to win a fight if you get in the first shot. You know that.
Oh, look at this. Hammerlock, crossface.
He knows how to wrestle.
Lot of wrestling.
Boy, he sure does.
Don't sell the big boss man short. We've seen in the past what he can do. Oh. Elbow into the bread basket, finds a mark. Look out. Nice single leg trip once again.
He's wrestling him. He's out wrestling the boss man. Which isn't hard to do.
Turns it into a nice half crab.
Chihuahua can out
wrestle the boy. Will you stop? Referee questioning Big Boss Man about whether he wants to give it up or not. You know the answer to that. Who does he remind you of, Brain?
He reminds me of a meter maid from Marietta, Georgia.
I'm talking about Dwight.
I thought you meant the boss man. I can't put my finger on it. But I've seen him before. But it's hard to pick his style up.
Oh!
Because he's changing his style. And when's the last time you saw the boss man manhandled like that? Even though he got hit with the box right at the beginning. Still, I haven't seen a manhandle like this.
I give credit where credit is due.
He's been out-wrestled. He's been outsmarted. Which isn't hard to do.
Got a chicken wing on right now. Can't see whether he has a crossface or not.
He doesn't.
You wouldn't know a chicken wing if it bit you.
I've been to Buffalo.
Oh, please. This is very painful here. Drawing that arm out away from the body. Anatomically, it doesn't work very well.
Rip the wing off. Rip the wing off.
Now he's got a half Nelson. They're halfway in.
I know a guy named Nelson who's a halfwit. Is that what you said?
Two count once again. So far, we haven't seen much offense from the big boss man.
No, I told you the guy's a quitter.
Beautiful fireman's carry. Takes him over and continues to work on that left arm and shoulder.
Now, he's taking a little too much time. Maybe. Maybe he just knows he's got him where he wants him. I don't know what runs through that man's mind.
Look at this. Oh, he's having his way with him. Power display as well.
Where is Doink going now?
Doink to the outside here. Why on earth would he want to do this? He's been having tremendous success inside the ring. Now he's gone to this. Well, he high risk move. He got caught. Well, maybe he's not as smart as we thought, Brad.
Maybe setting him up. I don't know.
And maybe it's time for a little law and order.
Maybe he took too much time. Maybe Doink should have stayed out of more.
Whipping for the ride. Wow! Oh, it's payback time.
Yeah, he's not going for a pin or submission. He wants to pound on him. Whoa!
Uppercut. Headbutt between the eyes. Look out. That'll wipe the smile off that clown face. In my book.
Well, your book is so small, it's not important.
Look, what is that? Horrid green stuff.
I smell something. Can you smell that? What is that?
I don't know. Doink, the clown has been disqualified here. As the referee took one look into the face of the boss man and reversed the decision. And rightfully so.
Could be blinded.
Could be some kind of permanent damage done here. Heavy price to pay.
Watch the eyes. Watch the eyes.
Victory.
Watch this. Watch this. See? You can see the... see? The smashing. He's happy now. He's happy.
What a sadistic individual. Keep your eye on Dwight the Clown.
You know, when you're the World Wrestling Federation champion, it's always in your best interest to size up all your opponents. When you think about Yokozuna, though, you're talking about somebody that's wiped out every single opponent he stepped in the ring with, undefeated. He squashed everybody. And that means Jim Duggan. Hacksaw Duggan was squashed like a grape, and everybody around the world saw it. Now, I know that I'm stepping in the ring with Yokozuna in WrestleMania 9 at Caesar's Palace, and I'm going to be the underdog. And I can accept that. But Mr. Fuji and Yokozuna, you better accept this. I've got the dedication. I've got the tenacity, and I have the excellence of execution. I'm the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. And when you step in the ring with me, you're going to find out that the bigger you are, the wider you spread. And you might have spread yourself just a little bit too thin. I'll see you in WrestleMania 9.
We're not talking non-title here. The only thing that turns me on is the gold. All that glitters is Shawn Michaels, the man that is solid gold head to toe. Tatanka, at WrestleMania 9, the biggest pay-per-view extravaganza of all time, I'm going to give you the shot that you think you deserve. Well, Tatanka, it's going to take more than you. It's going to take a whole tribe of Indians to defeat the Intercontinental Champion. I'm walking out of WrestleMania the champ. Shawn Michaels, it's you and me at war at WrestleMania. But we have faced once before, and I proved to all my people and all my brains, but most important, Shawn Michaels, I proved to you that I can beat you. And at WrestleMania, at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada, it's for all the gold. But Shawn Michaels, this is a vision with all my people. This is my destiny, and I will not let my people down at WrestleMania. Shawn Michaels, get prepared. Yeah!
Doink, the countdown has begun, brother, for WrestleMania 9. This is when you gotta step into the ring with Crush. You put me out, brother. You put me in the hospital, brother. You gave me a concussion, which almost ended my career. But, brother, you did not get the job done. At WrestleMania 9, the world is gonna experience a new Crush with a rage, brother, which is gonna explode just like a volcano. WrestleMania number 9 is coming, brother. And Crush is gonna be ready, Doink. WrestleMania number 9.
Bret Hart, we know that you've been watching us. And you know that my Yokozuna is undefeated. That he has squashed all opponents, including you, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Yes!
But come WrestleMania, it is gonna be your turn. We're gonna squash you and squat you and take the WWE.
Oh, snap.
Sayonara, ne?
Buzzard!
Incredible. Unbelievable. I can't get enough of myself. But you know, the challenge has been made. And it was accepted. He had to, Mr. Perfect, for WrestleMania 9, a showcase event. But now the stark reality sets in that you have to face me. The butterflies in the stomach, the sleepless nights, because you know that everything you based your career on is about to go up in smoke, because when you're defeated in WrestleMania 9, you will no longer be perfect.